Nk'uko mumaze iminsi mudusaba amasomo y'abana mwakifashisha mu rugo, turayabohereje kuri videwo kandi nta kiguzi tubasaba. Mukomeze kwiga neza mukurikiza gahunda yo kwirinda COVID-19.
Good morning once again, my learners. I'm very happy again to be in front of you for collaborating with you in the lesson of social studies. As you see in front, you have Unit 4, which is related about public places and public assets. Now, for this point, what we are going to learn about, we are going to see public places, what are they, and what is the importance of them. Then after, we shall see the problems faced by public places. And then, after ending the public places, we shall again study about public assets. Now you will see the difference between public assets and public places. So, before explaining well this point, I may first come back about the definition of public places. But before that, I would like to remind you that the public places is the same like important places. So, why we call them important places? You know that in English, when you say something is important, it means that it is useful. So now, we are going to see the definition of public places. Public places are places provided especially by the government and useful to all citizens. We can define public places as all places provided especially by the government, and those places are useful to all citizens. By info from this chart you have, I've tried to show you some public places. There, by observing this first building, you see that it is a bank. So a bank is public places because it is useful to people. People may go there for saving money and asking loans for developing themselves. Then there, we have the following, the church. That is another building which helps people to play God and became happy. And after that, we have what we call Amahoro Stadium. That is another building. This is, we call it recreation institution, where people go there for relaxing and reflecting. Here we have also Acadia National Park. This is like a forest. So parks also are public places because they are reserving wild animals where they attract tourists. There we have schools. So, this is, I've tried to write P1, P2, P3. I may continue even reaching in a university whereby this is called what we call education institution. Education institution also, it is a part of public places. Here we have museum. This one is called the historical sites, where people go there for getting some research and even looking how the past people were living. Not only museums, we have also genocide memorial sites. This also, it is a public places because people go there to see what's happened in the past time. Coming back again, we are talking about public places. My learners, I have told you that public places are places which are important to people, to all people, not private. They are for all citizens or all people. And there, nobody who can stop you wherever that you are going to visit that place is. No one who can tell you that you are not allowed to go there, because everybody is allowed to visit. So there, I have tried to name them. Where we have bank. A bank, it is what you call a government institution, which provides different services. In the bank, we can find different services, such as saving and borrowing. There in the bank, you can save your money for your future use, or can you borrow your money for organizing your project. For church, you know that all of us, we are some Christians, and others are Muslims. Here we can even mention Muslims. Church people go there to play God for getting friendship with the God and asking forgiveness. There we have Amahoro Stadium. This is also another public places where people go there for relax and also reflect their mind by watching different games take place there. Here we have Akagera National Park. We are talking about parks, not only Akagera National Park, we have also Virunga National Park or volcanoes. Also other natural forests which requires as a parks. There is also public garden, not only Akagera National Park. These are the examples I've given you. So this in Akagera National Park, you know in the park we can find what you call wildlife or wild animals. So those wild animals like lions, tiger, and different animals, people likes to visit them to see how they live, like foreigners, tourists came to visit them, and the government benefit from that, because when the visitors visit these game parks, they can pay some money, this foreign currency, and which help our country to be developed. We have even schools. You know, these schools, we can even write secondary, we can write university, we can write other different colleges. So these schools, people go there to learn and to get skills and knowledge. And after getting skills and knowledge, they develop themselves and they develop a country. There we have museum. I would like to remind you that you have many museums in Rwanda, like eight. There are eight museums. Some of them will have this historical house or historical museum where we call it Richard Kant. And you have also Liberation Hall Museum, which is located at in this Kigali, Kimihurura, in the parliament. And there is also Made in Rwanda Museum, which is located at Kanombe. And we have also Nyanza Museum, where we get the how the kings were living and the burial site of kings. Those are the museums the foreigners people came to visit. I would like to inform you that those museums you have visited in last year with our students who passed the well national examination, and in yourselves who are still in the P6, I would like to inform you that those museums where we visited you, will you go there yourselves and you observe what am I telling you. So the following is genocide memorial sites. We have many genocide memorial sites where there are many bodies of Tutsi who were killed during genocide, and then we find other tools used during that massacres against Tutsi, and then the things that they have. After that, I would like to tell you that there are some important genocide memorial sites which are known in the international, where there is Kigali Memorial Site, there is Nyamata Memorial Site, there is Ntarama Memorial Site, there is Bisesero Memorial Site, there is Nyarubuye Memorial Site, and there is Ntarama Memorial Site. There are others, but those ones I've said are known as in the international level. So here also we have the other public places where there is Amahoro Stadium, where people go there for relax and watching different games, and which helps them to do recreations and reflect their mind. There is a schools which are in what you call education institutions. Education institutions also are among the public places where there is universities, where there is colleges, where there is secondary schools, and primary schools in other schools. So those are public places. Dear learners, we are going to follow again the examples of public places without observing on this chart. For the first point, you have national parks. National parks are also the important places or public places where we have Akagera National Park. That is the example of the name of national park we have. There is Nyungwe Forest, there is volcanoes. We have also volcanoes and other natural forests. Those are what we call the names of some game parks we have. Apart from that, we have also in Rwanda lakes. And those lakes and rivers, they are owned by the government. So they are very good for us as citizens, because many activities are carried in those lakes and rivers. Some examples of lakes, we have Kivu, we have Mwazi, we have Mugesera, and others. Then for rivers, also in Rwanda, we have many rivers, where there is River Rusizi, which is in the western, where we have River Nyabarongo, River Kagera, and other rivers. And those rivers also, they are important to us because these fishing activities can be carried in those rivers and we get money after selling them. We have waterfalls. These waterfalls facilitate to get hydroelectric power. Where we have Rusumo Falls and we have Ndaba Falls, which is in western, and Rusumo, which is in east. We have also historical sites, as you have seen there, where there is genocide memorial sites and museums. Those are the parts of what? Historical sites. You see, by observing these ones, so even if you see they are there, but we can even include also other ones which are called the government institutions. For government institutions, as is written there, we have banks. Also, we have public schools and others. So, dear learners, let's analyze together the importances of those public places. I know that everybody knows that they are very good to us. Why? Because of the following reasons. All of us, we are going to share the ideas to see some importances of public places. So, you are going to follow them. These memorial sites. Provide us an employment. We are different people. We are different skilled people. And others get their jobs. Get jobs. The next one, not only for career of employment, we are going to talk about saving. Banks facilitate citizens Yeah, here we are talking about that the importances of public places where there is banks. We are coming back for banks, then after banks we have game parks, and we shall see others. So banks are public places which are useful to people because of what? You know that in the bank, the workers who are there, they have to get money at the end of months. So that is, they develop the workers there for getting those money, and they facilitate them to develop themselves. And that is the career of employment. So means that many people can get jobs in the bank and improve their well-being. And banks also, people save their money there. First of all, they save money for future use, and they save money in the bank for being safe. There is also what we call, people can get loans. When the people get loans, they can develop different projects. So you see that banks are very important to people because they provide different services such as employment and saving, even getting loans. Coming back for game parks, we have seen Acadia National Park, we have seen volcanoes, and even we have seen other natural forests. For them, what they provide to people, they improve countries' development, because when the visitors or tourists visit them, they pay money which we call foreign money or foreign currency. And those foreign currencies support the country or the government to be developed. We are going to see other importances of public places. Other importances of public places, as written on the blackboard, we have airports. You know that in Rwanda we have different airports. Knowing that the international airports we have, in Rwanda there are two. This one, Kanombe International Airport, and another airport which is international unit at Bugesera district. Those are the international airports. There is also local airports like Kamembe airports, Lubavu airports, and others. So what are the importance of them? Those airports facilitate quick export. What is the meaning of export? Export is a kind of selling our commodities outside of the country. That is export. Exporting means that transporting our local goods outside of our country. And then the imports. In Rwanda, we know that we normally export coffee and tea and others, but we get also abroad what we get out or what we buy from other countries, we call them those commodities imports. And those imports, we can talk about vehicles, we can talk about iron materials, electronic tools, and so on. Those ones we get from outside. So when we have airports with an aeroplane or airplanes, help our country to get development very fast, because wherever that we need some commodities from abroad, we can get them very easy due to these airports. And then we have another word. The airports help students to run their lessons abroad. We know that we have some students who run in America, we have some students who are in Asia, we have our students who are in Austria and other countries of Europe, even in other continents. How they can reach there? Without airport, they can't go there. So airport facilitate our students to follow their lessons outside. Then another public places, you have markets. Markets is a place where selling and buying take place. That is also another public place. Now, what is the importance of markets? So markets promote trading activities where selling and buying activities are carried in. And also in markets, we can get different goods that we want. So for helping us to improve our life. There is also schools. There are different schools, as I've said, where there is university, where there is colleges, where there is secondaries, where there is primary, and those are called what you call schools. Now, what is the importance of the schools? People in the schools, they improve knowledge, or they get knowledge and skills to our students, which give them a chance to get jobs. You know, you are in P6 today, but tomorrow will be in the secondary, and after tomorrow will be in university. Then after ending your courses, it will facilitate you to do what? To get a job, because you have skills and knowledge, and then those skills and knowledge, you implement them in what? In the market of work. So after getting a job, means that you cannot get the job without being educated. So the school are very public places, important to us, because it is where you get knowledge and skills. So dear learners, we are going to see, even if here we have some importances, there is also lakes and rivers where fishing activities take place, and we get also hydroelectric power, which help us to get different services. There is also government offices like a police station, and even government offices is where our problems are solved, and it is where we get different jobs in those offices. So let us study together the problems. Even if our public places are there, we are going to see what are the problems can be faced to our public places. So for again, and we see the problems can happen and the way of solving those problems. So all of us, we are going to analyze together those problems. So problem number one, there is what you call lack of. One point is lack of enough funds to build many schools. You know that in different areas, in the rural areas, there are few schools. That is because of what? Because of lack of sufficient money, sufficient capital to build different schools. That is the problems can be faced for our schools. Second one, problems of robbers. We have problems of robbers. That is another problem that can be faced to our public places because of what? Once the robbers attack our banks, that is the purpose, they have purpose of stealing money. So that is the problem is faced by bank. You know, in many days, have you been understood through the radio that there are many banks and cooperatives which were destroyed by the thieves and they steal money of citizens. So that is the problem is faced by the banks. Number six is problems of poachers. Yeah, the next point is problem of poachers. That is poaching activity. What does it mean? Poachers are people who kill wild animals irregularly without having any permission. So when the poachers kill the animals, these wild animals, sometimes they want to search homes, they want to get skins, and they would like even to get meat. As you know that these wild animals are important to us because they attract tourists. And when the poachers killed those animals, we cannot again receive the tourists. So that is the problem faced by what? Our wild animals or our game parks. The next point is even if the visitors are very good to us, but they sometimes they can cause the problems. When they became in many, in a small area, at that time they can cause what you call overcrowded. Overcrowded means that many people in a small area. And what is the effect? There they can cause noise pollution where some people they can what you call suffocation. People can be suffocated because of what? Lack of enough air. There is also pollution. Pollution in memorial sites. So you know that in our country we come different people who come from in different areas. And for example, they have their own way of living. And once, for example, they come with plastic bags, and after visiting the memorial site, they can even throw them somewhere else. That can cause what we call pollution in memorial sites. That is the problems can be faced to our public places. Lastly, we can say bush burners. Bush burners also, it is a problem because of what? You know that because of overpopulation in some areas, people started to do what? To burn the forest in order to get land for settlement or for land to do agriculture activities. That is also another problem faced by our forest, our natural forest. Now our runners, we are going to see how can we solve the problems of faced by our public places. We are going to see how can we protect our public places. Those are the ways of preventing these problems. We are going to see how can we overcome the problems that you have mentioned above. That is one. The way of controlling or the way of protecting our public places, first of all, making guards. Can make guards those people who are making security to our buildings. There is the reason why they would like to protect them against robbers and thieves. Second one, we can punish. Punishing poachers, those people who kill wild animals without having any permission. The third one, how can we protect, for example, our memorial sites? Making laws. Yeah, we have to write some laws on the wall such that if somebody wants to enter in, should read them before entering. Making laws to be followed by people who visit them related about sanitation. So that is about pollution. If you are coming with, for example, with a plastic bags, you can write them in your car, then you visit the place. So there is no need of throwing any dirtiness in museum and memorial sites. Now, we are going to see other ways of protecting our public places. That is what we call avoiding bush burning. Avoiding bush burning also, it is another way to be taken such that you can protect our public places. So, lastly, cleaning our public places. Yeah. The last point, even though there are others, we can also clean our public places. For example, classes, should be cleaned and rehabilitated. When you are rehabilitating, our classes can't be damaged. Or you can even clean our around of our government buildings, like station, like for example, other government institutions where we can get different services should be cleaned such that they can last long. So those are the ways that we can apply to protect our public places. So dear learners, you are going to follow the exercise related about this, so you may read them properly. What are public places? What are the importances of public places and ways of protecting our public places? So the exercise I'm going to write on the blackboard, you have to do them yourselves. Okay, we are going to explain those exercises I've given you on the blackboard. What are the public places? That is the first question. And the second is, mention any four public places you know. Number C is, how game parks are important to us and to our country. First of all, to us and to our country. First one, explain the use of museums. Enumerate any four museums are in Rwanda. Here we have four. Describe the use of lakes and rivers. Number seven, discuss the problems faced by our public places. Number eight, name any two game parks found in Rwanda. Number nine, how memorial sites are important to us. Number last, why do you run social studies? There you will give me two reasons. So, our runners, I thank you very well, your attention and collaboration by following this unit you have studied. And I would like to encourage you, to do these exercises well after reading well the notes written on the board, and after you submit at the time not greater than 5 p.m. I thank you very well for your polite and where you are following. Thank you very much. Stay home as usual, and even as we are at home. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.